I've heard about five different variations of my first name. Joseph, Joe, Joseph with an F, Jose from Mis Amigos en Guadalajara. And then there's that one guy in grad school who called me Giuseppe. Meanwhile, I don't think I've ever had anything similar with my last name, just Washington. The retrieval in Retrieval Augmented Generation, or RAG, is kind of like that. We all agree on the augmented generation part of the name, but retrieval comes in multiple flavors, and the retrieval strategy you choose can make or break your AI agentic system. And this is key. In any generic RAG system, where a user comes in and they have a query, and they come to your application, which itself is connected to your LLM, and you want to provide that LLM access to different knowledge sources, RAG works by fetching relevant chunks from your knowledge base and feeding them into the LLM. The quality of that retrieval method, though, determines how factual and relevant the answers will be. More methods, or some methods, I should say, are lightning fast, while others are more flexible when it comes to synonyms, context, and data that spans different modalities. So let's count down the top three retrieval strategies and end with the one that most teams are betting on today. Okay, starting with number three, sparse retrieval. This is a foundational classic method of retrieval. It's fairly old, it's about 50 years old, relying on keywords or keyword search. Sparse retrieval uses methods like TF-IDF, the well-known, as well as BM25. It counts how often query terms appears in your document and then scores the documents accordingly. Its pros are it's simple, fast, and scalable, but it doesn't handle synonyms or context very well. Still, in some cases, BM25 can outperform more expensive deep learning models on domain-specific terms. Question: when should you use it? Any situation where exact wording matters. So, short, well-defined queries, code search, logs, or legal clauses are all examples. And it doesn't require embeddings, so it's cost-effective and it scales really well. You're probably already using open-source examples like Elasticsearch and Apache Lucene, both built on BM25. And even Milvus now supports BM25 in addition to vector embeddings. Now on to number two, dense retrieval, aka or semantic workhorse. This technology is about 5 to 10 years old, so fairly recent. And in dense retrieval, both queries and documents are mapped into high-dimensional vector space, and results are found based on the semantic similarity, i.e., the meanings of the words, instead of exact matches. So this depends on embedding models. An embedding model, like the open-source sentence transformers models, takes text and converts that into vector of numbers. Texts with similar meaning land close together in that vector space where similarity is calculated using algorithms like approximate nearest neighbor or k nearest neighbor. Open source examples include Faiz from Meta or JVector, which is an open source high performance Java library that speeds up dense search or dense retrieval in enterprise RAG systems. Dense retrieval makes natural language queries shine. It's perfect for chatbots, customer service, and research over unstructured knowledge bases where people might phrase things in many different ways. It's powerful and context-aware, but it can miss rare or jargon-heavy terms. It's also not good with short, few-word queries. On to number one. Hybrid retrieval, aka the current state of the art. This one is the new kid on the block. It's only about 2 to 3 years old in practical deployments, and it combines the best of both worlds, vector plus keyword search. The semantic matching handles synonyms and concepts, while the keyword matching ensures that rare but critical terms don't get lost. Benchmarks show hybrid retrieval consistently outperforming dense-only retrieval, boosting both precision and recall. So how does it work? The query runs both ways in parallel, once as a vector embedding against your embedded knowledge set, and again as a keyword search. It then uses a fusion algorithm to merge results based on scores from both. The most common fusion algorithm is a weighted sum. So it picks a balance between, for example, 70% dense and 30% sparse. Another very popular method is reciprocal ranked fusion, or RRF, which doesn't use raw scores, but instead merges based on the ranked positions from each retriever. It works across use cases, but especially in domains with specialized jargon, such as legal or technical domains or medical fields. Hybrid is number one because it balances speed, precision, and recall. That's why it has become the default choice for serious RAG deployments, and also why offerings like Elasticsearch, Milvus, Weaviate, and DataStax AstroDB have all made it easy to experiment with hybrid retrieval. For some of you, this may feel like a Taylor Swift Eras tour, but with retrieval strategies and with the eras spanning the last 50 years. If you're a data scientist or developer, I encourage you to embrace the hybrid retrieval era, because sparse retrieval is fast and exact, and dense retrieval is context-aware and flexible, but hybrid retrieval gives you the best of both worlds, and that is why it's top of the list.